You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force has got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like it makes me feel like.
Thank you. on you today.
Other end of the globe. With over a 12-hour difference, the sizzling hot country, India, Yogesh Sharma tells us his first experience with snow.
It's different from India to Fargo. We are having very hot temperature, hot as hell in India. And here it's totally opposite. So yeah, on my first day I seen a snow and I thought that the college is gonna close. And I was sleeping in my room and I just calling to my friends like, hey, what's happening in here? So are the colleges closed or not? He said, no man, it's just a snow. It's the first time. The college never gonna close at that for the snow.
And everything becomes a new experience. Even everyday mundane stuff like food.
Like they're spicy in Sri Lanka, but not here. You know, people like eat sweet stuff here, basically. And I don't like the food that we have here.
Make up for the lack of spice we have here, people cook their own food at home.
Come and have never seen snow in India, so it's pretty good and very exciting for me here.
Yogesh has come here to Fargo, about to transfer to San Jose, California. But when the accreditation went up, he came to Fargo. He's overall been happy with this decision to come to NDSU. In NDSU, Sonia Dhaliwal reporting for SRT News.
In our out of control attitude. The whole, I deserve everything because I breathe attitude.
Ways that you're saving money.
For one, I'm living at home with my parents.
All right.
It's cheaper on the rent, cheaper on laundry, so because I can use my parents' washer and dryer for free. Not going out as much, occasionally with friends and stuff.
But not too many. We're 14-2, so actually 15-2. So we won 15, lost 2, and we're headed towards the right part of the season to be having some success.
One thing that makes this terrifying moment a little less chilling, a format they're competent at. We wanted to know what formats people are most comfortable with.
I find both multiple choice and short answer to be my strengths in test taking.
Apparently, just about 30% of a typical college exam will require your critical thinking and interpretive skills. The 70% lion's share will require your raw memory. Call it cramming power, or to put it gently, your ability to recollect information is very important. This reflects our modern college examinations, But not every teacher does this.
Our tests are a little bit different, where we try to test how well they can apply the information, how well they understand.
Also for Friday, be thinking of topics that we can really use as a
shift. How does it work in their day-to-day lives? How can they actually use it?
It's important to remember that teachers want you to do well and test understanding, not just rote memory. In NDSU, I'm Sonia Dhaliwal with SUTV News.
The girl was doing all kinds of stuff and then great to her. Oh yeah, I see ya.
What if you saw it? You're here. You got it.
Okay, good, awesome.
He's trying to earn some money with his picture.
Okay.
To get back there.
Is he drunk?
No.
Okay.
No, he's cool. He's just, you know, down and out. A lot of people are down and out these days.
Sure, the economy.
But he seems to be doing better.
Okay. Because we were at the car lot earlier, and we were thinking about giving him a little money to get going on his camera business, his photography business. He said he comes in here and uses a computer.
Well, how Fargo of you? Think of doing that for him. That'd be really nice.
So we were just kind of, we're going to talk to somebody, see if they knew him, and kind of give some information so we're not giving him money to go drink booze.
No, he's not a drinker. I never seen him drink. I think that'd be cool. Hopefully, yep, yeah. Because I don't know if he can handle another winter, you know. Not used to this kind of weather up here.
I said before, you know, do anything to get back.
Something like money you just can't buy. You get that inheritance from your uncle.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of good that does now.
Yeah.
Some money together here, so I can fly back to Tennessee to go see my daughter.
Okay.
I haven't seen her for a whole year.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
He died and he left all these cars. So yeah, I get pretty much like half the cars.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So I was like, that's sweet. So, but anyways, I already had everything anyways, and
you got everything you need.
nice car.
Hey, how's it going?
I'm doing good, man. How you Thanks. Guys doing?
Good.
Oh, I see you too, man.
I'm glad you came, man.
I'm not expecting to see you guys down here.
Yeah, we just got hanging out, chilling out.
Yeah, I suppose it's close to the train depot. So
yes, I always come down and hang out, have a cup of coffee, you know.
Who did you get your name before?
Oh, Joseph Wellness.
This is Brad. My name's Dan.
Nice meeting you guys. Wilmer.
Okay.
Joseph, nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you, dude.
Yeah.
So we're going to have a seat.
Well, yeah, come on, man.
Thank you. Yeah, we're hoping to meet up with you later on. We're going to talk about something.
Okay. Yeah, we're thinking a lot about it. Me and him, we're thinking a lot of possibilities and yeah, just seeing what we can do to maybe to help you out a little bit.
Well, I'm glad you guys have thinking about it.
I got some money back from them, and
yeah,
they're right, and I was thinking, yeah, I was like, I want to buy you a new camera. How's that sound?
Wow!
Man,
that's a blessing right there.
Yeah, I got some, because later on in the house, and I took it out, and I didn't want to, you know, throw it back in the bank or whatever, and I was like, hey, you know what, I could use it, so I get some cash to
thank you, get going
in the business.
Oh, I don't know how to thank you, man.